To be a complete architect, you need to have only three categories of software in your toolset. Every time I hear a new program come out with a new version that each architect must use, I start panicking and wonder, what do I need to learn now? So let me show you what programs you will need and why on three different levels. So the first category is modeling. You need a program to translate your ideas into something buildable. Floor plans, details, schedules, 3D models, sections, site plans, etc. Look, I'm not gonna lie to you, you need to learn BIM software. Archicad, Revit, Vectorworks, go ahead and choose. If you are just starting out, take a look at some places you would like to work in the future and look at what software requirements do they have. I would first base my decision on that. Second, choose the one that adjusts better to your pocket. Suppose you are working as an independent architect, and in that case, you need something that will not break the bank. Understand that each country, region, office, studio, and university has its own software culture. So you can know Revit in its entirety, but you can also go to work at an old school office that works in AutoCAD, but you just have to make sure you learn BIM software. The second category is visualization. Suppose we are talking about a solid base for being an architect who can design, draw, and communicate effectively. In that case, you need a visualization tool that will get you from a 3D model to a decent visualization. For this, I recommend a starter plugin like Enscape. It's straightforward to use and learn. It's plugged right into your BIM software, and you can get pretty cool results if used well. If you are looking for a free version, you can also use Twinmotion or D5 Render. The third category is presentation. You need a tool that will help you present the drawings effectively and renders you have created. This can be something like Adobe InDesign, but many architects can create introductory presentations also with Photoshop, Illustrator, or even PowerPoint. This is the basic tool set you need to start. Don't overwhelm yourself and panic, just learn this. If I were put as a recent graduate and had to learn three programs, these would be it. Now, having that said, knowing just three programs is not necessarily going to give you an edge amongst your colleagues, and you probably won't stand out much in job selections. So, can you get better than this? Of course, intermediate level. For our first category, modeling, you need a program where you can polish your 3D model and make it ready for visualization. Again, you will have to choose depending on where you are, where you want to work, and your budget. Some options are 3D Max, Rhino, SketchUp, or Blender. In some cases, these programs can even be helpful in the concept phase of a project where you are coming up with ideas that you will later pass on to your BIM software. So having the ability to model fast and sometimes complex forms and programs that aren't as rigid as BIM programs can be an advantage. For our second category, visualization, you need programs where you have more space to personalize, add assets, and create complex visualizations with the model you have made. I would suggest starting with Lumion D5 Render or moving on to render engines like V-Ray. When you begin by learning V-Ray and all of its complex variables, you won't have such a hard time understanding it when you move on to a real-time rendering engine, different than if you start the other way around. For our third category, presentation, I would have at least three different programs on which you should have an intermediate level: Photoshop, Illustrator, and InDesign. Photoshop will help you perfect your visualizations or create collage renderings. Illustrator will help you improve your line work like floor plans and sections, and InDesign will help you craft presentation boards, portfolios, and booklets to make you stand out. Now, how does your toolset look? With an intermediate level, you can switch from one software like Revit to another like Archicad. You can create a decent render in V-Ray or Lumion, and you can polish drawings, present them with Adobe software. But can you get better than this? Well, of course. For our first category, modeling, I would suggest adding plugins to make you more productive and allow you to model complex forms or model with data. Depending on your base modeling software, you'll need specific plugins. Some examples are learning Grasshopper for Rhino, learning to use Rail Clone or Forest Pack for 3D Max, Dynamo for Revit, Curvy Loft or Quad Face Tools for SketchUp. Next is visualization. Here, you should get deep into a complex visualization tool and know the ins and outs, understand how to troubleshoot common problems, and understanding how to create complex materials from scratch, preferably PBR materials, will add realism to your visualization, and having a sense of composition will make your images visually attractive. Third, presentation. You will probably add some programs that can help you present in different ways. Learning software like Premiere Pro and After Effects will help you communicate your architectural ideas through video form, which in today's world is always necessary. So now you look like an architect that can receive almost any task and know how to deal with it. But Can you get better than this? Of course. Now you know what software you understand better, which is more suited for the type of projects you are working on, and probably you have understood that you don't need plugins as you thought. Perhaps you can become an expert in, for example, Archicad. If you are ultra productive, understand easily, and can quickly create a project, you don't need anything else. Second, rendering. Master composition, color, light, and storytelling. Yes, that's right. I didn't say V-Ray, Lumion, Enscape, but just composition, color, light, and storytelling. You can use Enscape or V-Ray, or you can have a shitty laptop or the latest graphics card, but by knowing this, you are on another level. Learn how to construct a persuasive presentation. Your goal is to convey ideas to an audience. You must make your argument visually, and your task is to be straightforward. So now the question is, can you get better than this? Well, of course. That is where the sponsor of today's video comes in, Skillshare. Have a specific skill you're trying to learn? Skillshare is the perfect place to start. From photography, illustration, to graphic design, freelancing, and more, you can find classes that will match your goals and interests. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for anyone who loves learning and wants to explore their creativity and learn new skills. Invest in yourself and your personal growth. Some benefits of Skillshare is that it's ad-free, so you can stay in the zone while you're exploring new skills. New premium classes are launched each week, so there's always something new to discover. And the entire catalog is now available with subtitles in Spanish, French, Portuguese, and German. One class I recently took is Productivity for Creatives, Build a System That Brings Out Your Best by Thomas Frank. Like many of the classes on Skillshare, it is short and to the point and talks about using templates to maximize productivity, how to delegate correctly, and some bonus conversations with other creatives and how they are productive. The first 1,000 people to use the link in the description will get 1 month of free trial of Skillshare. So take a look at your tool set. What can you add? What is not that necessary? What helps you be more productive as an architect? What is taking time away from you? Now, if you want to learn more about lighting, composition, and visualization, overall, check out these videos right here that will for sure give you an edge. So now the question is, can you get better than this? Well, of course.